Okay, with this simplified probability distribution, we can start working on some problems. So we'll try one of those now. So our example problem number one is, what percent of scores are above the mean? All right, so you could draw it like this, and what we're interested in is all the scores that are above the mean. All right, so to solve this problem, you can go over to your simplified distribution, your simplified probability distribution here, right? And so the mean is 0, so we're interested in everything above. So we need to add this 34 and this 14 and this 2 to tell us what percentage of scores are above the mean. You add those together and you get 50%. So half of the scores in this distribution are above the mean, which is not at all surprising, of course, because this is a normal distribution and it's symmetrical, so half the scores have to be above and below the mean. Okay, so the next example we'll work through, example two, is what percent of scores are above z equals 1. Okay, so again, we can draw this out to locate where we're looking for. So, you know, you can label these for now. 1, 2, 3, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. So we're interested in scores that are above z equals 1. So there's z equals 1. So we want all of those scores. So we're going to have to add those up. So in between 1 and 2, that's 14%. And between 2 and 3, that's 2%. So 16% is the answer. So 16% of scores are above a z-score of 1. All right, so we're going to do a third example problem, which is what percent of scores is above z equals negative 1 and below z equals 2. So I'm looking for between those two z scores. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, -1, -2, -3. So above -1 and below 2. Okay, well, those are the, that's the area we're looking for, so we'll add up those components. So in between -1 and 0 is 34%. There's another 34% in between 0 and 1. And then between 1 and 2, that's 14%. So we'll add these up. 30, 60, 70, 82. So 82% of scores are between negative z of -1 and a z of 2. It's often the case that you'll have a problem where the question provides you the raw, the score in the raw units, like inches for height, but you need to solve these probability questions with it. So I'll do an example that's like that. So let's say, what percentage of women are taller than 61.5 inches, which is also 5'5". So somebody who, a woman who's 5'5", might be especially interested in this question, for example, right? So the first step we're going to need to do here is we're going to have to take this raw score and transform it into a z-score, because these are z-scores. So we need to take whatever we have and turn it into a z-score before we can use this distribution, right? So for women, we know the population mean and standard deviation, so we'll use the z-score formula for that. And population mean was 65. The population standard deviation was 3.5. So now we'll calculate the z-score. So z equals 61.5 minus 65 divided by 3.5. So that would be negative 3.5 divided by 3.5. So we're talking about a z-score of negative 1. So I'll draw my normal distribution, put in the lines for all those z-scores. 0, 1, 2, 3, negative 1, negative 2, and negative 3. And we're looking for the percentage of women taller than z of negative 1. Well, that's going to be this part, and that part. All right, so between negative 1 and 0 is 34%. 0 and 1, another 34%. 1 and 2 is 14%. And another 2%. So we add all this together, 30, 60, 70, 84. So 84% of women are taller than a z-score of negative 1. And notice, there's another way you could have solved this if you wanted to. So since this area all adds up to 100, what you could have done instead is calculated the area over here and subtracted it from 100, and that'll give you the same 84%, right? So if we did it that way, you start with the area of the whole thing, then you subtract that, that, and that's it. You subtract that. So 100 minus 16, it's also 84%. So those are two different ways to calculate the 84% of women who are taller than a z-score of negative 1, or equivalently, the 84% of women that are taller than 5 foot 5 inches. Okay, so now we're going to talk about another way the probabilities of a normal distribution are commonly used, and that's to calculate percentiles. So a percentile is the percent of scores below, and only below, a given score. So we'll look at an example. I guess this would be our example number 5 for this overall topic. You could say, what is the percentile for z equals 2? Right, so here we can again draw our normal distribution so it's easy to keep track of just what it is we're looking for. 1, 2, 3. And we're looking for, we're working with a z equals 2, and this is, we're only interested in below. So that's here, 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 and here. All right, so the percentile for a z score of 2, need to add this 2 for this, 14 for that area, 34, 34, and 14. So you add all of those up, and you get 98%. So the percentile for a z-score of 2 is 98%. That means for somebody whose height is 2 standard deviations above the mean, they're taller than 98% of other people. So that's pretty tall. So usually when you're working with percentiles in the real world, you don't start off looking for the percentile of a z-score. You start off looking for the percentile of a raw score. So let's do an example like that. Example number 6. Here, what is the percentile for a woman who is 65 inches tall, right? And 65 inches, that is 5 foot, 5 inches. Okay, so we need to transform this into a z-score so that we can find our location of this raw score on this distribution. So we know for women that the population mean is 65, the population standard deviation is 3.5. These are inches. So we'll use the population formula for the z-score. And for our woman, she's 65 inches minus the mean of 65 divided by 3.5. That's going to end up giving us 0. So her z-score is 0. She's right at the middle of our distribution. And we're looking for percentile, so it's always below that score. So we want to know what the area is under 0. So we have to add up everything over here. So we need this 2% plus this 14% plus this 34%. And we add that up, because that's all of it, and we get 50%. So a woman whose height is 65 inches, 5'5", her percentile is 50%. So half of all women are shorter than her. And of course, by implication, half of all women are also taller than she is. But being taller is not part of the percentile. It's just calculable from a percentile. And when you're, if you have kids, you're really going to be familiar with these percentiles because as your child's growing up, you get percentiles for the kids' heights and weights. And they take your kids' raw scores, they transform them into z-scores like this, and then they use these kind of probabilities. And that's how they're doing it. Okay, so I'm going to do one more example. That is the most complicated of all the ones so far. So what if what we want to do is calculate a raw score from a percentile, right? So for example, what if we're trying to figure out what is the raw score, the height for a woman at the 84th percentile. Right, so we can't translate percentiles directly into raw scores. What we need to do is change this percentile into a z-score, and then once we have that her z-score, then we can calculate her raw score with the z-score formula. So for starters, we'll figure out what this z-score is. So if we just add it up as we go on the bottom, right, because percentiles are only below. So this would be 2, just between 3 and 2. Between 3 and 1, that's 2 plus 14, that would be 16. So we've got to get all the way up to 84. So if we go from 3 to 0, that's going to be 50. We're still not there yet. But then if we add this other 34, that's going to give us our 84%. So this woman's z-score is 1 because the area underneath that adds up to 84%. So now we know her z-score, so we can use our z-score formula, calculate her raw score. Population mean is 65, population standard deviation 3.5. So we know the z-score is 1. We want to figure out what her score is. So to give myself some space here, I'm going to delete, or I'm going to erase this distribution. Okay, and now we need to get this x by itself. Multiply both sides by 3.5. Those cancel out, and we get 3.5 over here. I'll rewrite that here. 3.5 equals x minus 65. Still need to get this x by itself, so we'll add 65 to both sides. Those cancel out. And here we end up with 68.5. So a woman at the 84th percentile is 68.5 inches tall. And this is the simplified way of looking at the probabilities for a standard normal distribution. And I've introduced it this way to hopefully keep things simpler because when you're actually working with these probabilities, you have to use a table that is, it's much more precise than this. And it'll tell you for any, like, for any much more precise z-score, like for z equals 1.65, it'll tell you what the probabilities are for that. But I want to give you the overall strategy for how to solve these kinds of problems before I introduce the Z table, the table that has these more specific probabilities for very specific Z scores. And then the only new skill you'll have to do is learn how to use that table rather than the simplified version of these distributions.